I was sent a pack fresh Yu-Gi-Oh! Collection. What's up, guys? We're back with another epic collection video, but before that, I have a quick giveaway. I will be giving away these three cards. There isn't evenly matched in there. All you have to do is like this video, be subscribed, let me know what you think about this collection. I think these are pack fresh cards from what I remember from the guy sending me a message on Instagram. This box is actually pretty heavy, so I don't know what's going to be in here. First of all, there is a note in here. Let's read it and see what we're going to get. Hey, Ruxin, I be a big channel, your fan. Hey Ruxin, I've been a big fan of your channel for quite a while now. I believe you were around 15k subs when I first subscribed. That's awesome. That was kind of a while ago at this point. A while back, I was big into the card grading scene when it first took off around 2016-17. That was a very long time ago at this point. I really enjoyed the thrill of buying boxes and packs to hopefully grade the holos after and then trade sell afterwards. After a few years, the prices just got too much for me, so I let it go. But I still had a small collection of freshly pulled cards and cards that are already graded that I never got around to do anything with. I thought it might be cool to try and support the channel and send you the collection to see what you think in a possible video. Hope you enjoy. Congrats on switching to YouTube full-time. Message me on Instagram after. Preston. Seems like even some graded cards in here. So we've got like it's almost like a graded mystery box at this point that we don't know what we're going to pay for. We're going to go through these things one at a time. First off, we have an opened first edition starter deck Yugi. Let's see what's inside. So it looks like he opened and graded the Dark Magician. Inside, okay, there's the back. That's pretty normal for those. We have a full starter deck Yugi without the holos, it looks like. Wow, check this out. Winged Dragon, Guardian of the Fortress, Baron, the Celtic Guardian, Dark Hole. It's like, I almost don't want to like shuffle him too much. Summon Skull, very nice. Castle Walls, Yami. Mizurazame, Yami got the Monster Reborn, very nice. Silver Fang, all right, just some really cool cards in here. We don't have to go over all of them because we know what's in Star Deck Yugi, but really cool to see that. Then we have a similar one. We have a Joey, so it looks like that's going to be the same thing. We'll take a quick peek in here. Yeah, it looks like it's going to be the same. Yeah, it looks like we're going to have all the cards in here. Are there more cards in Joey? It feels like there are more cards in here. Swordsman of Landstar, love to see that card. Wow, that is really cool. So like pack fresh cards. Next, there is a deck box. So let's see what's in the deck box. All right, we've got some, looks like some extra sleeves in the back. We've got the Summon Skull from Duelist Pack Yuki. Cool, the Dark Paladin, the Javelin Beetle. Oh, some Tournament Pack 1 stuff. These are actually pretty expensive rares. So we want to make sure they're all sliding up a bit. We'll deal with that afterwards. Blue Medicine, just a bunch of TP1 rares. So maybe he opens it. Oh, Quagar Hercules. This card has gotten very expensive. Let's check the actual condition on it. And it got expensive because I think Bee Trooper, which is random, but it's also just really rare. So yeah, that card looks really nice. I wonder if he opened some TP1. I bet he did. Because 2016-17 TP1 was like not that crazy in terms of value compared to now Skullmeister. Starstrike Blast. I didn't know this is where this is from. That's really cool. Secret rare. Buster Blade Retro Pack 2. So Retro Pack 2 was dirt cheap in terms of super rares back then. So that makes sense why he didn't grade those. Oh yeah, some Starstrike Blast cards. Formula Synchron. That's a cool card. Make sure you watch Octane series this week. Just saying. DD Survivor. Rage Flies of Blue. We got the, oh, Dark Magician Girl. Oh, a Dragon Seeker from TP4. Okay. So a lot of really cool stuff in here, but the the Blackback, have I ever heard of that card? It just sounds a little bit inappropriate, but we're just going to keep going. Ultimate Insect, Sorcerer Dark Magic. See, a lot of these cards were worth absolutely nothing back then, and now they have gotten to be, some of them are actually really valuable, and some are worth like $10. There are also some sleeves in here. There's even more. There's like some penny sleeves and other stuff like card savers. Then there's a binder, which I don't know if it has anything in it. Oh, it does. Wait, does it? No, it's just very stiff. Okay, there's nothing in there. We have a monster binder. Cool. We have an actual full-size binder here. I think there's actually stuff in here. Okay, Orica cards. Let's pick this up. You guys know how it goes with the binders. We got to pick it on up. We got the Blue Eyes White Dragon Seeker Rares. These were cheap back then. Now they're actually somewhat valuable, which is cool. Oh, Caius is in here. That guy's expensive now. Effect Veiler Super Rare is worth something. There's a hair in there. It's reminding me of Moist Critical. Okay, Exodia pieces. I mean, a lot of this stuff is really cool, even if it's not like a ton of money. Okay, we've got an Honest. We've got a Thunder King Ryo, I think is worth a little bit. Dark Magician Girl. Wow, a lot of really cool cards in here. Yes, a few more nice cards. There's a Trishula is a very cool one. Oh, there's a Ghost Rare. That's a Star Eater. It actually doesn't even look like a Ghost Rare too much right there. It's a little bit scratched up, but that's a nice one still. First edition. That card was very cheap for a long time, so makes sense why you still had it. Pot of Greed Secret. Love to see that. Mystical Space Typhoon Secret. Pot of Duality. Is that a Secret Rare? No, it's a Super Rare. Okay. Some other cards like Pot of Desires. Okay, just a few cool cards there. Trap Hole is in there. We got Magic Cylinder. Okay, a bunch of gift cards. Those are actually worth like, I think they were worth like $5. I don't know if they got reprinted or not. Okay, is that it? That is it for the binder. And finally, we have these wrapped up packages, which appear to be the graded stuff that he's still at. So let's see what he didn't consider worth like selling or getting rid of at that point. Or maybe it's part of his collection. I don't know. Let's just see what it is. Actually, I don't think this one is graded stuff. Let's go with this one first. Oh, okay. Here's the pack fresh old school cards, it seems. All right, we have gotten everything out. Let's see what these are. So we have a first edition Nobleman of Crossout. I'm assuming this is what he meant by pack fresh. Let's find out what it doesn't mean. Like, yeah, I think it sounds like he actually pulled some of these. This, I mean, just the feel of it. I can tell that it feels like it came out of a pack. Yeah, just the feel of it. It's like the grit is still there, which is really cool. So the sad part about this is this guy was really into grading stuff, and then it just got crazy expensive, which a lot of people can relate with. Back in 2016 and 17, it was just like a fun hobby. You didn't have to pay that much. You could pay like $6 or something to grade your cards, and they'd come back and they'd be worth 20 or 30 or whatever, you know, something like that. So it wasn't like insane. And now it's like to grade something $150. We're still waiting on bulk to come back to make it even remotely affordable. And you know, this stuff, you just can't send this stuff anymore. Like an off-center nobleman, not worth $150. Just not worth sending. So you just can't do it anymore, which kind of stinks. That's why we have not been able to send in a lot recently for grading videos. Hopefully they will, you know, lower the prices. We can send in a bunch of bulk and they'll come back in 2 years and we'll have a lot of content then. Then we have, oh, a premature burial. So there's going to be some cool cards. And it looked like that was like mint condition. I mean, it was off-center, but it was like mint condition. Premature Burial. We've got a Grave Robber, PSV. Oh, look at this. Duelist Pack Kaiba. It's unlimited, but these first edition ones are crazy. Oh, Ring of Destruction Ultimate Rare. That's awesome. Oh, look at this. Tour Guides, one unlimited, one first edition. Wow, those are actually super nice. And these are playable in a lot of decks still, so that would be something I would love to have just in like a playability binder. I don't know what to say there. Bryonic Dragon, the Ice Spirit. That's a beautiful card. It's not super expensive, but it's a very nice one. Here's a Light of Destruction Secret Rare. That's actually really cool. And this card's playable. It's actually pretty good for, because it destroys special summon monsters. Not bad. Also, speaking of, I mean, auction series, guys, a lot of references here you guys don't understand, but they are here. Retro Pack 1, B-Skull. That's actually awesome. Retro Pack 1. Did he open some Retro Pack 1? He's going to have to let me know that. That's really cool because I have not opened a lot. Oh, Retro Pack 1 Secret Rare Relieve Monster. Yes, this is a secret rare. You've probably never seen this card before. Let me know in the comments if you have not seen this card before because I want to know how many of you guys have not. I bet it's a lot because it's random. Like, I barely even know about that card. Retro Pack 1 Penguin Soldier. Just, oh, look at all these Retro Pack 1 cards. Here's Retro Pack 2. Nice. And then we've got Retro Pack 2. Oh, this is, what is it? Gladiator's Assault. Oh, Crossroads of Chaos. I kind of forgot about that. Yeah, Gladiator's Assault is the actual other Gladiator Beasts. First edition Red Eyes Darkness Metal Dragon is pretty valuable still, I think. Then here are all the foils from the decks, or the super rares at least. We've got the supers here. We've got the Scapegoat and the Penguin Soldier. I figure he has graded the big ones at this point. First edition Azura Priests. Love to see these. If we're just considering that all these are like mint condition, which I think they probably are if he pulled a lot of this stuff. And back in 2016, 17, all the stuff that you're opening to get this stuff is not that crazy expensive, which is an interesting world to imagine because right now everything's insane. Mirror Wall, Fairy Meter Crush, more Pharaoh Servant stuff. Here's another Pharaoh Servant. A Nobleman, here's another one. He's got two of them. That's awesome. Slate Warrior. Oh my goodness. That is. Oh no. Okay. I thought this was Retro Pack. That would have been crazy. I hope it's not Retro Pack because I don't have enough money to buy all this. Okay. Copycat. That's cool. The Necro. Okay. Here's a bunch of supers. These have really not gone up too much. These Tactical Evolution supers, but they are cool. Here's more Tactical Evolution. We have Chthonian Emperor, Desert Twister. Oh, Ultimate Rare Desert Twister. That's cool. I like that. Fairy Meteor again. He opened a lot of Pharaoh Servant seems. Ooh, Labyrinth of Nightmare. We've got the Kaiku the Ghost Destroyer. Mystical Elf. That's a reprint, so they still had reprints back then. And then the Dark Magician Girl, nice. Here's a bunch of like top loaders. So let's see what's in here. We've got the Torrential Tribute Retro Pack 2. Is that a common? Interesting. Okay, there's a bunch of them. So these look like they're a bunch of commons from Retro Pack 2. And a Security Warp. Orb. Nice. We've got the DD Designator First Edition Invasion of Chaos. Nice. Chthonian, Legacy Hunter, Rose Warrior of Revenge, Roland, Toon Bookmark. So he did open a little bit after that. Looks like he got to some Toon Chaos, which a lot of people were really into that set, so it makes sense. And then we have a Lila, Lightsworn Sorceress, Starlight Road, the Cephalon, Dark Lord, or Dark Hole, not Dark Lord, and Call of the Haunted. So these are kind of some cheaper stuff, but still some cool stuff. So you can definitely tell these were like kind of the extra and not really worth much back then, not even worth sending for like $5, $6, but all the values have gone up. So they're actually pretty nice cards now. All right, the final thing we have are stuff that he actually did grade, but he did not get rid of. So let's see exactly what this is. This is kind of exciting. I mean, who knows what it's going to be? It's like a PSA return, but we don't know what's coming back. And as you guys can tell, it's the 40 million cert. So it has been a very long time since these were graded. Unlimited Delinquent Dragon Duo, Spell Ruler EN. Yezzy probably wants this, to be honest. I don't think he grades his ENs, though, but that's pretty cool. So Delinquent Duo, that's a PSA 10. We've got a 9 Turbo Warrior. That's the promo from the 10. Pretty cool. We've got Mystical Elf PSA 9 reprint. Very cool to see that. Yeah, I'm guessing a lot of this stuff will be, like, not super valuable stuff. Okay, reprint, polymerization, because he did say he got rid of most of his best stuff. So let's see what, if anything's crazy. Gores, maybe something's gone up a lot since he sold those. Gores Secret Rare from Retro Pack 2. That's pretty nice. Another Gores. Nice to see that. I mean, it looks like he opened a lot of Retro Pack 2. United We Stand Retro Pack 2. There it is. We've got another United We Stand Retro Pack 2. All right. Dark Necrofear. Oh, yeah, we pulled that one. That card looks really good for Retro Pack 2. Tyrant Dragon Retro Pack 2. It's like a whole Retro Pack 2 set PSA 9. Look, limited removal. Is it a whole Retro Pack 2 set? It seems like it. Oh, a Gem Mint 10. Okay, we got a 10. Nice. Luster Dragon TP5. Okay, that's cool to see. It's just a near mint to mint 8, but still nice. Thunder Giant from the Lost Millennium. That's really cool. And then we're ending with the World Class grading. Yeah, it's straight up World Class. Notice how this card is perfectly centered in the case. Nothing wrong with it. Fiend in the Great Sphinx. Look at it down there. It's literally like getting bent, I think. That's hilarious. But it's a Gem Mint 10, baby. Oh, yeah. Very nice card. That's hilarious. All right, guys. Let me know what you think I should pay for this collection. You don't get to see ungraded stuff as much anymore. Shout out to TCG Trusted Cards, Toe and Fo Show, Tomato Juice, Noah J, Hawaiian Yu-Gi-Oh, Stanley, Mike Nance, and Mimic Gecko. Thank you guys for supporting the channel, and I will see you guys next time. Peace.